Kellyanne Conway, counselor to the president. Thanks for being on the show. Nobody wants to hear kids cry. I get that. You get that. We're both parents, and we got warm blood pumping through our hearts. The president could stop the policy tonight, but he won't. Why?
Christopher, allow me to repeat myself. Thanks for giving the White House a platform tonight from yesterday, since people will have amnesia. I said yesterday, I'll say to you tonight, I'm a mother, I'm a Catholic, I'm a person with a conscience. I agree with everyone, including the president, the first lady, and everyone who has said that they don't want children to be separated from their parents unduly. Do you know there are three conditions by which minors and adults are separated in these circumstances? Two of the three are to protect the children, and somehow all of you are glossing past that. So let's review the facts. The first is, if you cannot establish a familiar or custodial relationship between the adult and the minor, we have a 315% increase in the last few months alone in fraudulent cases, children being smuggled, presenting as a family. You've got to care about these children also. The second reason that you would separate a minor from an adult is if you feel like that child could be harmed. You see sometimes these children clearly don't want to be with the adult man they're presenting with, and you need to find out why that is. And the third reason is that if the adult has broken the law in entering the United States and now will be prosecuted, you can get to a port of entry and present for a credible fear asylum case. And the Secretary of Homeland Security is reminding everyone today to do that. Go to one of the ports of entry and present the credible fear case. I only wish that you would play the audio tape, the videotape, that CNN would do a surround sound program of the hundreds of thousands of Central American minors who have come over the border into this nation over the last several years. We don't know where they all are. Do you? Does CNN know that those girls haven't been drug trafficked, sex trafficked? Do you know that they're with adults, family members, people who love them? Do you know that they're alive? So you can play all the audio tape and videotape you want. You show me what happened to each and every one of those girls. Why were the girls the ages of your teenage daughter and my teenage daughter, excuse me, getting birth control injections because they faced almost certain rape?
Listen,
so if we want to talk about children, we need to talk about all children.
I know, but Kellyanne,
there's
no reason for us to go down any avenues of speculation.
No, you get to choose what you want to emote about.
I don't think tonight's a night to fight. I think this is black and white. The only thing that changed here.
You heard me talk about the compassion part. So did the first lady.
No, but you glossed right over it because you have to.
No, I'm not glossing over
anything. The administration created this situation. I was on it.
Where were you in 2014?
I was on it.
Were you?
It was wrong then.
So go ahead, roll those tape. Let's see. You're calling the Trump detention centers.
Yeah, well, they are.
Isn't that a clever branding?
He changed the policy.
And the Obama detention centers had what in them?
He changed the policy.
Families.
The reason that the Bush. Well, I let you speak. You want to talk facts, let's do it. It's really all I have in this situation, because obviously the emotion isn't enough, right?
So you don't care about these Central
You knew
American
this was going
minors.
To happen. You
we
knew
don't know
when
where
you
they
increased
are.
Enforcement and you didn't expand your capacity to deal with people, you knew we'd make this moment. You knew it would come.
Do you
so
know
what
how
I'm saying
capacity
is,
gets expanded? Do you know the answer to that? Congress has to fund the expansion. Tell them to work more than 2 or 2.5 days a week.
Homeland Security gets a ton of money right now. You could have allocated it differently. And even if Congress would act, they should act. I want people to start the hashtag do your job and have them find common ground and act on it. They're certainly part of this problem.
The president has called for that.
But the president has called for something else as well, a new harshness. We will prosecute all cases. The law did not change. You know that, Kellyanne. It hasn't changed in two administrations. What has changed is the politics. Catch and release, bad, weak.
No,
they don't show
the
up
politics.
For their hearings. We're strong.
No.
Jeff Sessions will prosecute
Wrong.
Every case.
The law,
that's why we have the kids
in
crying.
There?
No,
there
it's a fact,
there?
Not
no,
a
if
question.
You if you want to interview me, then ask a question, because I'll give you an answer now without
Why did
question.
You change this policy when you knew it would lead to these
Excuse
kids
me.
Being separated this way?
Excuse me. Christopher, it's very simple. We have a law in this country, okay? And I've already talked about my capacity
Does
for compassion and the way we all feel.
Kids
Hold
and families.
On. Christopher, nobody said it did. Let me finish.
That's
Congress passed a law a very long time ago that it is a crime to enter the country illegally.
Mm-hmm.
If they don't like it, if you don't like it, they should rescind the law or change the law. In fact, if I were a Democrat right now, I would say, you know what, I just want open borders. I want to own it. Let's see what happens. Why don't they have the courage to do that?
No need to do that.
Why?
Because
Why?
It doesn't have to be all or none. This is a misdemeanor. Why don't you guys go out there and catch scofflaws, jaywalkers? They make my life miserable.
Excuse me.
They're a bigger problem for me than illegal entrants are. Round them all up and then figure out what to do with them.
Christopher, that is such a callous way of not answering my original question, my original challenge to you to tell me with certainty, tell the world tonight on your show that you know what happened to all those Central American girls.
Of course I don't know where all of anything is. I don't even know where all my kids are on any regular basis. But you don't know where the kids are that you're separating from families.
That could have been said by somebody who, that's terrible.
Hold on, Kellyanne, you don't have the high moral ground on this. You changed a policy to impress your base. You got to pop in the polls with them, and you're okay with the instruction and harshness. Just own it.
How dare you? If you want to live in a nation, a sovereign nation that doesn't have borders, then you go right for it.
Nobody's asking for that.
And the people in your party, excuse me, say we want open borders. Just do it.
Nobody's asking for that.
Let me tell you something.
They're saying don't take kids from parents when you don't have to. The way Bush chose not to. The way Obama chose not to, Kellyanne. You know the play here. It's an ugly play.
Now, listen to me. I have said to you what the president said steps behind me on a different network, or actually to the press gaggle where there were CNN reporters 3 short days ago. We've all said it. Nobody likes it. However, nobody also likes people coming and smuggling children. It is a huge enterprise. Why aren't you at the border screaming every day to stop this $500 trillion enterprise?
I've actually covered human trafficking.
Great.
I've actually covered what happens on the border. By the way, this administration hasn't been a big fan of doing something about it. What you want to do is arrest people for crossing illegally, which is a misdemeanor.
No.
That's what you're doing.
Those people, if all you've done is broken the law by crossing illegally, you will get a very swift adjudication. And you see Senator Cruz's bill tonight doing very close to what the president called for last October. Where is Congress? That's 8 months ago, Christopher. He asked
for
them to double the number of immigration
judges. Why didn't he build more facilities? He loves to build. Why would he start prosecuting cases where he knew he would separate families and not have anywhere to put them?
If all you did was not come through a port of entry, if you went between the ports of entry, and you, the only law you have broken is crossing over illegally, you will be, and you agree to that, you plead to that, you will be adjudicated and you'll have time served, and that's normally
so you're
it.
Saying none if, of the 2,000 kids law, that was separated from their parents just came across the border illegally.
Did I
every
say that?
One of those cases has something else to turn your question on you. You know that
no,
for a fact,
but you,
Kellyanne?
But you know that all several hundred thousand Central American boys or girls are living safe, happy lives here in America. Right, Chris? No, because everybody turns their back on it when it doesn't fit their political narrative. And I am sick to my stomach that we are still talking about common sense immigration reform when this president, right behind me in January, invited Republicans and Democrats in the House and the Senate into the cabinet room. CNN covered all 55 minutes of it live. Which name for me the Democrats who said to the president, Mr. President, you weren't here in 2014, but we were, because God knows they've all been here for too long, forever. We were here in 2014. Sir, we want to tell you that was a very bad summer. We had an explosion, a surge over the border of Central Americans, and we don't know what happened to the minors. We want to work with you to make sure that never happens again. Who said that in that room? Tell me. Put them on your show. They all want TV time.
Why is the alternative to waiting for Congress
to
put into
practice,
prosecute all illegal entrants, and balloon the population of families that you have to separate? Why was that
your answer? Probably on an audio tape crying somewhere that you don't wish to find or to play, or maybe a video tape.
What are you talking about? You won't let me in the facilities. I would go right now if I could get in.
No. I'm talking about the girls and the boys who came over from Central America over the last 4 years. None of these senators.
So your argument is we already had a problem. So what's wrong with us handling it this way?
No, I'm saying that. No, you act like it got invented last week, and this is everybody's problem. But everybody, Christopher, has to be part of the solution.
This is why they did catch and release.
No, they enforced it.
This is why Operation Streamline under Bush was not made manifest.
Okay, let me ask you a question.
It gets too harsh. It's too complicated.
Let me ask you a question.
And they chose compassion. You didn't.
If you think it was compassionate, these family detention centers looked compassionate to
you? No, I think what you're doing right now lacks compassion.
I've told you already, and I'll repeat it so that those who are trying to cherry pick this interview get it right for once, that I am a Catholic, I'm a mother, I have a conscience. I stand with the president, the first lady, and everyone else who has said many different ways, Christopher, that nobody likes this result. At the same time, You have to recognize what the Secretary of Homeland Security said today. We have a 1,700% increase in asylum claims. Christopher, we need the people who have credible fear.
Over many, many years, it's up 1,700. But how is this a deterrent? You've got rising numbers coming across the border, so certainly it's not the scare factor that you want it to be.
So,
if you have
such a conscience, what do you want it to be? It's not,
why don't you tell the president,
stop this policy?
Nobody
tried to make it a scare factor. The president is going to Congress tomorrow. Let's see who shows up. Let's see who shows up, because so far, every time your party has come to the White House and anywhere else on TV, all they want to talk about is
the Dreamers. I don't have a party. I look at all these people the same way. They're people who aren't getting things done for the American people. That's how I look at Congress right now, writ large.
Awesome.
But General John Kelly said when he was at the Department of Homeland Security, we believe this will have a deterrent effect. He used the language because that's what you want to send as a message.
That was over a year ago, and the Homeland Security Secretary did not say that today. So, Christopher,
I know, today she said something that doesn't make any sense. At least he was being honest. The only thing that changed is your policy, and now you have this spin from the White House that the law is the problem. The law
hasn't
changed.
You're spinning it because you won't admit that immigration in this country and border security has been a vexing problem for many years. This president has said,
it's easy to
give me money for the wall.
It's easy to admit that.
And this catch and release into the interior, secure our borders with different technologies, but also with physical
barriers. Your problem
barriers.
Is that you want to pick that like we have, like this is
merit-based.
Game of Thrones, and we have like the wildlings coming across the border and they're infesting our country and they're such a virus.
No,
you look at the numbers, they don't pose the kind of criminal threat that you say. You won't go after all the employers that draw them into this country.
That's not true.
No, those are big donors and Republicans. We're not going to go after them.
How dare you?
But you'll demonize the little people coming over.
I'm sorry, how did they verify work exactly well when President Obama was
where in your 70-point plan is to go after the employers?
How dare you try to say
how dare I what?
State
facts? It's a fact.
Oh, that's not a fact.
You're not going to shame
your opinion.
Me. When you're separating kids on the border, Kellyanne,
you're not going to
shame me.
Don't go back to
not
that.
Tonight.
Every time you back yourself into a corner, like a nonsense argument about donors, then you're going to go back to
the big corporate owners. They donate to both parties, and that's why they get protection. And that's why the family that comes across the border, they're a threat. Probably MS-13, and if not, certainly up to no good.
Are you laughing about that?
But the corporations.
Hey, Christopher, are you laughing about MS-13?
I'm laughing that you
want
to paint everyone who comes across the border as a drug dealer, a smuggler, or a gangbanger.
Well, when you're done talking, I'm sure this will really help. But listen, if you want to go tell Juan Pina, if you want to go tell those parents who were the First Lady's guests at the State of the Union this year, whose teenage daughters were savagely murdered. The MS-13 gang's motto is rape, kill, control.
And
you're laughing about it.
You think
it's nothing?
Go after MS-13.
You think it's nothing. You think it's nothing. They've overtaken the middle schools.
You're putting words in my mouth because you're in a bad spot, and I get it. But I just don't know why you don't fix it. Why doesn't the president say?
Because I'm not on the side of child smugglers. I'm not on the side of MS-13 gangs. This president wants to end that. And you know what?
Nobody would come after you for getting gang members.
The permanent separation
between
the children.
Child smugglers. The problem is you're just separating families
between Laura Wilkerson and her child, between Jameel Shaw Sr. and his son. All these people who have been killed at the hands.
And they all matter, but your solution doesn't address their problem.
Have you gone and listened? Are you playing audio tape of them weeping at night, missing their children? They're permanently separated from their children.
Are the kids who are crying on the tape, are they the ones that caused your problem?
How dare he? I don't have a problem.
You've got a big problem with this policy.
No.
This is a big problem. You've got two out of three people in the country against
you
on this policy. Two out of three.
Just cut it out and try to unpack this intelligently. I have already told you on the compassion side how we all feel. Then I try to bring up
no, but the compassion side is just words because the president created the situation, Kellyanne, so he doesn't get compassion points. You don't get compassion points when you change the policy.
Yes, he deserves compassion points.
To separate families. No compassion points.
When you have Senator Kamala Harris on in a little bit, I would like you to ask her that as Attorney General of California, she prosecuted, about a million felons at different times? How many people that she prosecuted that she knows were prosecuted? How many of the people actually went to jail? We're separated from their children. If I commit a crime and I go to jail, analogy. I'm separated from my four children.
It's not a good
analogy. It's one of
the many
reasons
these people
I won't
are felons that you're talking about with her when she prosecutes them. This is a misdemeanor that you want to make something
violent.
But listen, I hear you about that issue. I have to give you a chance to talk opioids. I want to keep my word. Tell my audience what has changed and what it means, please.
Sure. But remember, border security also has to do with keeping the drugs out of this country. So much of it comes through the southern border. So much of it comes through our mails. This president has a three-front war against opioid crisis and drug demand overall. First, prevention and education, so that we are teaching our youth, be a somebody, don't be a statistic. We are trying to reduce the stigma and the silence that attaches to chemical dependency and drug use. Opioids is tricky, Christopher. It starts in the medicine cabinet.
True.
That tiny little bottle bears the family doctor, local pharmacy, familiar things. It's legally prescribed, but if you misuse someone else's prescription, it's not good.
True.
And we have 64,000 Americans died in 2016 from drug overdose, including opioids. Also, prescriber education. The president has called for a 30% across-the-board reduction in new prescriptions over the next 3 years. He's already bending the curve in the right direction. We see a lot of support from the pharmacists, from the physicians, actually from legislators right, left, and center, which is great. Number two, treatment and recovery. I think expanding access to MAT, these medication-assisted therapies that we know work, having that rules change, having CMS, Medicare, and Medicaid granting waivers so that we don't have empty hospital beds. There's some 40-year ban on the 1115 waivers, okay? I'm going very quickly here.
Thank you.
But third one is interdiction and law enforcement. Do you know every single week in the news, except not on the news, unfortunately, there's a new seizure of fentanyl that shows it could have killed millions and millions of people. In Nebraska 3 weeks ago, they seized enough fentanyl to kill 26 million people. What is fentanyl? Fentanyl is a synthetic opioid. It is 50 times as strong as heroin, 100 times as strong as morphine. It's an instant killer for people. It's being laced into marijuana, laced into street drugs, laced into others. And we want to raise awareness. We have new ads out. They started a running on broadcast, including, I believe, your network today. Mm-hmm. And on Facebook and Google and elsewhere, we've teamed up with the Truth Initiative, which has a trust relationship with 18 to 24 year olds. The Halo audience is between 15 and 30 years old. They have combated tobacco use in this country, and we've teamed up with the Ad Council, 75 year history of being involved in major public service announcements. We have to find a solution together. We call this the crisis next door. This president, this first lady, very involved.
Good.
The entire administration, whole of government approach. I don't think you talk about it enough. So thank you for CNN tonight, at least giving us 2 minutes time on it.
Listen, I appreciate it. Every time you have an advancement there, you can come on here. You can talk about it.
We have
open arms for that. It's a huge scourge in our society. Everybody should know it.
And Kellyanne, we should agree with the first lady. Pass all the laws, adhere to all the laws, and show heart. We've got to be able to do both as a nation.
It's a phone call away from getting changed to stop those kids crying. Let's see what happens. Kellyanne, thank you for being with us. Appreciate it.
Expanded. Do you know the answer to that? Congress has to fund the expansion. Tell them to work more than two or 2.5 days a week.
Homeland Security gets a ton of money right now. You could have allocated it differently. And even if Congress would act, they should act. I want people to start the hashtag do your job and have them find common ground and act on it. They're certainly part of this problem.
The president has called for that.
But the president has called for something else as well, a new harshness. We will prosecute all cases. The law did not change. You know that, Kellyanne. It hasn't changed in two administrations. What has changed is the politics. Catch and release, bad, weak.
No,
they don't show
the
up
politics.
For their hearings. We're strong.
No.
Jeff Sessions will prosecute
Wrong.
Every case.
The law,
that's why we have the kids
lurking
crying.
In there?
No,
there
it's a fact,
there?
Not
no,
a
if
question.
You wanna if you want to interview me, then ask a question, because I'll give you an answer now without
Why
your
did
question.
You change this policy when you knew it would lead to these
Excuse
kids
me.
Being separated this way?
Excuse me. Christopher, it's very simple. We have a law in this country, okay? And I've already talked about my capacity
Does
for compassion
and
the way we all feel.
Kids
Hold
and families.
On. Christopher, nobody said it did. Let me finish.
That's
Congress passed a law a very long time ago that it is a crime to enter the country illegally.
Mm-hmm.
If they don't like it, if you don't like it, they should rescind the law or change the law. In fact, if I were a Democrat right now, I would say, you know what, I just want open borders. I want to own it. Let's see what happens. Why don't they have the courage to do that?
No need to do that.
Why?
Because it doesn't have to be all or none.
Oh, you know, it has
this
to
is
be
a misdemeanor. Why don't you guys go out there and catch scofflaws, jaywalkers? They make my life miserable.
Excuse me.
They're a bigger problem for me than illegal entrants are. Round them all up and then figure out what to do with them.
Christopher, that is only wish that you would play the audio tape, the videotape, that CNN would do a surround sound program of the hundreds of thousands of Central American miners who have come over the border into this nation over the last several years. We don't know where they all are. Do you? Does CNN know that those girls haven't been drug trafficked, sex trafficked? Do you know that they're with adults, family members, people who love them? Do you know that they're alive? So you can play all the audio tape and videotape you want. You show me what happened to each and every one of those girls. Why were the girls the ages of your teenage daughter and my teenage daughter, excuse me, getting birth control injections because they faced almost certain rape?
Listen,
so if we want to talk about children, we need to talk about all children
I know, but
at
Kellyanne,
all times.
There's no reason for us to go down any avenues of speculation.
No, you get to choose what you want to vote about.
I don't think tonight's a night to fight. I think this is black and white. The only
you
thing that changed
talk
here.
Talk about the compassion part. So did the first lady.
No, but you
so
glossed right over
Everybody
it because
no,
you have
I'm not
to.
Glossing over
because
anything.
The administration
Where were you
created
in 2014?
This situation. I was on it.
Where were you in 2014?
I was on it.
Were you?
It was
so go
wrong
ahead, roll those
then.
Tape. Let's
Hold
see.
On.
You're calling the Trump detention centers.
Yeah, well, they
Isn't
are.
That a clever branding?
He changed the policy.
Isn't that? And
he
the Obama
the policy.
Detention centers had what in them?
He changed
Families.
The policy.
Families.
The reason
detained.
That the Bush. Well, I let you speak. You want to talk facts, let's do it. It's really all I have in this situation because obviously the emotion isn't enough,
so
right?
You don't care about these
You knew
American
this was going
minors.
To happen. You
we
knew
know
when
where
you
they
increased
are.
Enforcement and you didn't expand your capacity to deal with people, you knew we'd make this moment. You knew it would come.
Do you
so
know
what
how
I'm saying
capacity
is,
gets
Kellyanne Conway, counselor to the president, thanks for being on the show. Nobody wants to hear kids cry. I get that. You get that. We're both parents and we got warm blood pumping through our hearts. The president could stop the policy tonight, but he won't. Why?
Christopher, allow me to repeat myself. Thanks for giving the White House a platform tonight from yesterday, since people will have amnesia. I said yesterday, I'll say to you tonight, I'm a mother, I'm a Catholic, I'm a person with a conscience. I agree with everyone, including the president, the first lady, and everyone who has said that they don't want children to be separated from their parents unduly. Do you know there are three conditions by which minors and adults are separated in these circumstances? Two of the three are to protect the children, and somehow all of you are glossing past that. So let's review the facts. The first is, if you cannot establish a familiar or custodial relationship between the adult and the minor, we have a 315% increase in the last few months alone in fraudulent cases, children being smuggled, presenting as a family. You've got to care about these children also. The second reason that you would separate a minor from an adult is if you feel like that child could be harmed. You see sometimes these children clearly don't want to be with the adult man they're presenting with, and you need to find out why that is. And the third reason is that if the adult has broken the law in entering the United States and now will be prosecuted, you can get to a port of entry and present for a credible fear asylum case. And the Secretary of Homeland Security is reminding everyone today to do that. Go to one of the ports of entry and present the credible fear case. I such a callous way of not answering my original question, my original challenge to you, to tell me with certainty, tell the world tonight on your show that you know what happened to all those Central American girls.
Of course I don't know where all of anything is. I don't even know where all my kids are on any regular basis. But you don't know where the kids are that you're separating from families.
That could have been said.
Hold on,
by somebody who,
you
that's
don't
terrible.
Have the high moral ground on this. You changed a policy to impress your base. You got to pop in the polls
wrong.
With them, and you're okay
How
with the instruction
you?
And harshness. Just
How
own
dare
it.
You? If you want to live in a nation, a sovereign nation that doesn't have borders, then you go right for it.
Nobody's
you,
asking
and the people
for that.
In your party, excuse me, say we want open borders. Just do
Nobody's
it. Let me ask
asking
you a question.
For that.
Let me tell you something.
They're saying
if you,
don't take kids from parents when you don't have to. The way Bush chose not to. The way Obama chose not to, Kellyanne. You know the play here. It's an ugly play.
Now, listen to me. I have said to you what the president said steps behind me on a different network, or actually to the press gaggle where there were CNN reporters 3 short days ago. We've all said it. Nobody likes it. However, nobody also likes people coming and smuggling children. It is a huge enterprise. Why aren't you at the border screaming every day to stop this $500 billion enterprise?
I've actually covered human trafficking.
Great.
I've actually covered what happens on the border. By the way, this administration hasn't been a big fan of doing something about it. What you want to do is arrest people for crossing illegally, which is a misdemeanor.
No.
That's what you're doing.
Those people, if all you've done is broken the law by crossing illegally, you will get a very swift adjudication. And you see Senator Cruz's bill tonight doing very close to what the president called for last October. Where is Congress? That's 8 months ago, Christopher. He asked
for
them
to
double the number.
Or why didn't he build more
judges.
Facilities? He loves to build. Why would he start prosecuting cases where he knew he would separate families and not have anywhere to put them?
If all you did was not come through a port of entry, if you went between the ports of entry, and you, the only law you have broken is crossing over illegally, you will be, and you agree to that, you plead to that, you will be adjudicated and you'll have time served. And that's normally.
So you're saying none of the
2,000
kids that were separated from their parents just came across the border illegally. Every one of those cases has something else. To turn your question on you, you know that for a fact, Kellyanne?
No, but you know that all several hundred thousand Central American boys or girls are living safe, happy lives here in America. Right, Chris? No, because everybody turns their back on it when it doesn't fit their political narrative. And I am sick to my stomach that we are still talking about common sense immigration reform when this president right behind me in January invited Republicans and Democrats in the House and the Senate into the cabinet room. CNN covered all 55 minutes of it live. Which name for me the Democrats who said to the president, Mr. President, you weren't here in 2014, but we were, because God knows they've all been here for too long, forever. We were here in 2014. Sir, we want to tell you that was a very bad summer. We had an explosion, a surge over the border of Central Americans, and we don't know what happened to the minors. We want to work with you to make sure that never happens again. Who said that in that room? Tell me. Put them on your show. They all want TV time.
Why is the alternative to waiting for Congress?